Hi guys! It's another tutorial today! So excited! My name is Vera Sachs and tutor for the day, Mozart. For those of you that are new to this channel, this is Mozart's music channel. Stay tuned and keep learning!
Alright guys, thank you for joining us today. It's always my pleasure sharing it all with you on the saxophone. Last week, I taught you something that looks not too needful, but some people feel that, well, if you are familiar with the key, you are familiar with the key. Yeah. Now, some keys can be so familiar, but they have limitations. Now, these limitations are just there. You might use time of rehearsals to master it, but you cannot compare key F sharp, the way it is arranged on the sax, with key C. Key C just gives you that, okay, why will a learner start from key C? Why not start a learner from key F sharp or from key G sharp or from key F sharp? So that's why we are teaching these things. It's not as if the teachers don't know why they start a beginner from key C. That's because key C has the advantage. Now, of course, you can practice key F sharp over and over and over that key C becomes something you're not too used to. Yes, but the limitations are there. That's why we taught you how you can master those keys that seem difficult so that every key becomes equal as far as the advantage of getting those keys is concerned. Now, we titled it part 1, so I am forced to do part 2, but the part 2 is not going to be, it's not going to take your time. Now, I want to quickly show you how to do grace note on those keys, because grace notes are fast alterations between notes. So if you are playing F sharp, most likely you will ignore grace notes, because having those fast alterations will not be easy if you have not mastered your alternate fingering chart and if you have not mastered your trill fingering chart that I taught last week. And so today, let me just show you how you will do grace note, let's say on key F sharp. So F sharp, you have F sharp like. I'm doing Zilatola so. Now, what is this Zilatola so that I'm doing now is I'm going to go Zila, this is your Z, this is your La, Zila, this is your To, then La so open. Zila tola so. Now the way you will do it is when you go zila to come back to to, you don't need to release this. You just go zila tola, zila tola, zila tola, zila tola, zila tola, zila tola. You can get it like zila tola. Well, there's no problem with that. But as far as it concerns being making it a fast alteration, you will need to go zila tola so, 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 zila tola so. So instead of me to go, okay, go. I find this faster and smoother for me. Now the next one is, this is your D re, this is your Do re, this is your D re, this is your Mo re Do. Instead of going D, D re Mo re Do, D re Mo re Do, so you go D re. Instead of going Mo re Do, you go D re Mo. You release only this. You get D re Mo re Do, 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 D re Mo re Do. Now the next one is mommy family, mommy family. How do you get it? Now, instead of going, mommy, family, don't release this. Just go, mommy, only this one. Just feel this. Family. You only release it when you're going back to your day. So go. That's why I use it and I'm enjoying it. If you like it, please make sure you learn it. Alright, so let's take another key where you will need this same thing I did. Let's take key E. Key E is when you go to key E to go mommy family, you don't need to go mommy family, you don't need to release this mommy family, just go mommy family, mommy family, mommy family, mommy family. Now to go dire more do on key is very difficult. You need to use this. You can't go. You can't use this to slow F sharp. You can't use F this F to slow this F sharp. So you have to go. You have to go. Not. You have to go. You can. You cannot go. You can go. So if you want to slow between F and F sharp, the key to use is this one, not this one. So you go, dire more do, dire. So you go, dire more do, dire more do. No go. But when you are going to dire, your time. When you are slowing re, you use this. When you are playing re, you use this. So dire. More do, delay, more, delay, more. So that's how to alternate between your normal Franklin chart and your alternate Franklin chart. So, delay, delay, more do, delay, more do, delay, more. Don't go delay, more do. Because to live here and come here, here and here is difficult. So it's better to just come here and come here. So that is just one or two things that, honestly speaking, they look minor. They are very little knowledge. They don't look like the circular breathing that you know. You, a lot of people really watch that video. But this is where these little things are the reason why you find it difficult playing as fast as you imagine to be. So please don't ignore this knowledge. If it was not important, I would not be sharing it with you because we need to go into improvisation. But before we go into improvisation, these are things that I will just be doing. I won't have time to be teaching you again. So I decided that let me just clear this air so that when we get to improvisation, I say, okay, let's go and improvise on F sharp. If you are struggling, I will not be at fault because I have taught you one or two things that I learned over the years that will help you master F sharp. Now, so that dire more do, dire more do, dire more do, dire more do, and so on and so forth. So if you have challenges with your key, if flat. Okay, let's go to E flat. So do dire more do, dire more do. You can't go dire more do. You can't go dire more do, dire more do. No, you have to now use this. This is easy. Easy, easy. Apart from that, the more do, I don't think anything is a problem on E flat. So, what of key B? Yeah, I'm using it again here. Zilatolazo, zilatolazo, zilatolazo. Mm-hmm. I'm using it here again. This same. And so on and so forth. So guys, if you know all the keys, it'll be very easy when we're teaching you modes. Because mode is like, I can explain mode on a particular key using all the sharps and flat, putting it inside that particular scale.
Yeah.
I can also relate modes into a key. For example, if I'm teaching you minor now, the minor alternate key that you can use for your key C is E flat. So rather than just say do mo fa fi so to do to so fi fa mo do, you see the same thing as la do re re mi so la la so mi mo re do la. Now, so if you know all the keys, you'll be able to flow from the minor into the minor relative, the relative minor of that key, rather than actually playing on the original key.
Yeah.
It's only you that know that, okay, presently I'm in this key. But if somebody asks you, which key are you playing? You say, I'm playing C minor. But actually, you are actually on the E flat in your mindset. So that's why, first of all, she convinced me that, see, I have to first of all teach you guys how to master all these keys. So that when I'm teaching you minor scales, all the mode, the Phrygian, the Lydian, the Locrian, I can actually tell you that actually these are the notes, actual note that you're playing on that particular key. But if you relate it to this relative key of that particular mode, which will be far easier for you as a musician,
yeah,
you will discover that is where you must learn all these keys. And that's the next class that we're going to be taking from here. That's the next set of class that's going to come your way. So please make sure you have all these keys. See, you are not supposed to have a favorite keys.
Yeah.
You are not supposed to have a favorite key, because if you're going to go into jazz improvisation, where especially you want to have inculcate some modes into your play, you have to know all the keys, like I said. So Verasax, how were you able to learn all the keys?
All the keys. It was not easy, but you just have to. When I discovered that saxophone is not like keyboard. Now you can just transpose.
Yes, you cannot transpose. That's the truth.
I cannot transpose. And you go for a program. You hear somebody start singing or working, you start wondering.
You look as if you are not a saxophonist at all.
You just look stupid. You look like you don't even know anything here. Because
it's not your key.
It's just different. Like,
so how were you able to?
I had to just learn the thing. Like, I had to just learn.
Start all over from each key.
Like, you are learning each key as if
you are just learning.
As if you are just
so learning. You learn your permutations on that particular key.
Thank you.
Then you go to your grave notes.
Everything
you know, you see, you start transcribing it into your key, other keys.
And the encouraging part of it was what really encourages me was when he told me that playing modes and all those minor keys.
You can do it relatively.
I can do it relatively. I said, wow, it's true. So I started learning.
So when you are on key D, for example, if you are playing on key D,
I can just rub something on key F.
On key F. So that gives you a minor.
That gives me my minor.
Provided your root note is in place.
Yes.
Which is your D.
Yes.
Your D. So when you are running F from your D, just make sure you land on your D, isn't it?
Yes.
So, and it makes so much sense. So before you know, you started learning those keys.
Yes, now. That you were running. Because I wanted to run modes.
You know, it's like you want to run Dorian.
Honestly,
if you want to run Dorian on your key F, you don't have a choice. You must come to your E flat.
Exactly.
You don't have a choice. So, because to run Dorian on your F, mm-hmm. if you're on C now and you want to run Dorian,
yeah.
you have to go back to your B flat.
Yes,
so, you just have to learn B flats, whether you like it or not. And then one other thing that later helped you was what I taught last week.
Yes.
You were able to now know one or two things that will make the fingering easy for you.
Yes.
So guys, we're not joking here. Please make sure you get these things right. All right, that's the part two that I promised you about how to master these difficult keys that you call the sharps and the flat. All right, for those of you that really love that teaching, make sure you subscribe. Make sure you continue to follow us, because presently now we are going into what we call
improvisation.
How are you going to improvise on all of these stuffs? That all the scales, you are going to bring all the scales together, the mode, the chords, mm-hmm. everything, all the permutations. We are going to face that class from now onward. But while we are talking about improvisation on saxophone, I am having a thought of introducing another instrument, bringing in other teachers. While saxophone continues in improvisation, other instruments begin to start from the beginning. Vanessa, what do you think about that?
That would be very, very encouraging.
Because we are done with theory. Just as we are done with theory. As far as saxophone is concerned. Every other theory you will meet on saxophone, you will meet me in our studio, in the audio studio. That's our sound studio. This is our video studio. We're going, the next classes we'll be having will be in our audio studio, where we can really be grooving and having some studio jams coming your way right on this channel. All right, so what do you have to say? All right, take care, guys,
please subscribe. Thank you for those of you that are subscribing. Thumbs up. Make sure you have all your keys.
All right, Vanessa, thank you.
Bye
guys. All right,
see you next Tuesday.